Welcome to the CLIMAX Academy Live. I'm Jim Miller, the Global Training Manager. This video series we've been doing is kind of a good introduction to some of our equipment. Today we're going to be doing an overview of the 2350 that I have here set up. You'll be watching a video on it. During the video, if you have any questions at all, go to the bottom of your screen to the Zoom Q&A. And we'll be having a time right after the video plays that we'll have a question and answer period. So as always, I like to start off with safety. I always wanna make sure that I do what we call a risk assessment. And that's, I look around the area that I'm gonna be working in and I make sure that there's no obvious hazards, nothing that I'm gonna trip over, no close obstructions that the machine might come in contact with or that I might come in contact with. Safety is our number one priority, and I always want to ensure that and reaffirm that whenever I'm making any adjustments to a machine, I want to disconnect it from power. That's very important. I want to watch out for sharp objects, chips, cutting tools, pinch hazards, anything that could potentially damage me or the machine while it's operating. So now that we're comfortable with our surroundings, And we know that we're going to be working in a nice, you know, clean, safe environment, then we can go ahead and move on. So again, while the video is playing, if you have any questions at all, go ahead and submit those to the Zoom Q&A at the bottom, and we'll get to those right after the video. Hi, my name is Jim Miller. I'm the Global Training Manager for CLIMAX Portable Machine Tools. And today we're going to talk about the model VM2350 Globe Valve Grinder. So currently I have the 2350 set up on this Globe Valve. And let's just kind of walk through the components. So this unit comes with either an electric 110, 110 volt, or a pneumatic drive component. The main spindle allows you to go down into the valve, and the spindle is spring loaded, so it automatically puts pressure against the seat as you're lapping. The quick and easy setup fixture allows you to center the machine within the valve, and it has a wide adjustment of operation to it. It also has the ability to depress the spring so I can actually put spring pressure down onto the body of the machine itself and put pressure against the planet wheel down at the bottom that's actually on the seat, and then the planet wheel itself. So let's do a little component recognition here. Like I mentioned before, I can run either a pneumatic or an electric motor, and to change them out, it's just one bolt that unclamps the clamp here, and what that does is that clamps right around the nose of the motor, and as you can see, there's a little ball drive detent where that rests on a pin, and so I just have to have that clocked in a 180 degree position so that'll slide in and locate on that pin. So it goes through the gearing down to the ability to set the height or the depth, we call the throat depth of the valve. So the deeper I need this to set into the valve, the higher this would be up onto the main shaft of the machine, or the shallower the valve, the farther down. And you can see the valve that I'm set up here is not a very deep valve. So it allows me to clamp that wherever I need to get to the seat of the valve from the bonnet. Then we have the planet wheel at the end, and this is the part that it floats to the angle of the overall seat, which should be 90. But this allows it to make a perfectly flat seat because it can float and not try to correct the angle. It just makes it flat. And then let's go ahead and pull this off, and we'll talk a little bit more about the components that go onto the planet wheel. So I want to demonstrate here how this interface works. There's a driver on here, just a pin driver, that goes into this pocket. And how that works is this clamp raises and lowers by tightening the screw on the face. And as that raises, it gives me clearance to come out over the top of that ball.
So that's how that can just float and drive on the end of that, on the end of the spindle. Now we're at the description of the planet wheel itself. And you'll notice that in the kit, I can lap a valve seat anywhere from 3 to 14 inches. That's the range of the 2350, of the VM2350. So to get to that range, I have a variety of arms that allow me to extend, and I have a variety of planet wheels that allow me to extend. So this setup that I have here is appropriately sized for the valve that I had the machine initially in. And so as you can see, I've got the shortest of the arms in the medium-sized planet wheel, and then I set the diameter range based on the increments on that are stamped onto the back of the planet wheel. So in this case, I'm using a boron coated wheel that has the ability to have the most aggressive grinding or the most metal removal. And then I can also go down to a smooth disc and put a piece of a sticky back aluminum oxide sandpaper and go down a variety of grits to get down to a 400 grit sandpaper. And then I also have a cast iron disc that allows me to put lapping compound, so I can go clear down to be able to put a below 8 finish on the face of that valve. So let's talk about the clamp mechanism. There's a few things going on here. It's kind of like the Erector set when you're a kid building the little toy that allows you to move things around and center things up. This is no different. It has a clamp on the foot itself that allows me to turn the foot. It has a clamp on the rod that allows me to slide the clamp in or out based on the diameter of the flange. So I have that in three positions. It has just a simple C clamp that allows me to attach it to the flange of the valve. And I also have a built-in ratchet that allows me to raise or lower. I can feed one direction, reverse it, or feed the other to raise and lower the machine. It's basically just sliding it in the clamp. So I want to be careful that when I clamp the machine in, that I don't have it so tight that I can't move the body of the machine up and down. And again, like I mentioned before, that spindle is spring loaded, so I just have to put a little spring pressure against it to push it against that seat. So that pretty well covers how the clamp works and how it expands and centers in the valve. So the whole purpose of using the valve lapping machines is to correct or to remove any corrosion that's in that seat that's possibly causing the valve to leak. So in this case, I'm going to go ahead and make a mark on the seat with a felt pen just so you can see how the machine can remove that mark. We've watched the video. It looks like we have a couple of questions here. And so, again, even while I'm answering the questions, you can submit those questions. So let's go ahead and go to that first question, John.
Can you clean the boron-coated wheels, and how long do they last?
Yeah, absolutely, you can clean them. A wire brush, just knock the dust out of them. Also, I mean, I've used mineral spirits just to flush them. You don't want to put an oil on them because that's going to even draw more of the grit to it. How long they last, that's a tough one, right? Because it really will depend on the material that you're grinding, the surface condition of the material you're grinding, you know, how hard the material might be, how soft. That's a tough one to estimate, but they definitely can be cleaned.
When you set the machine in the valve, how much pressure do you apply?
Yeah, so it has an automatic spring pressure to it, and it is progressive. So what I like to do is I like to start out with a light amount of pressure, and then I can advance the machine down depending on how much material I have to take off. Obviously, when I'm getting close to my finish and I'm doing the final lapping, I'm going to want a pretty light pressure because I'm not going to want any deflection. You know, my whole goal here is to make a flat surface. So the more pressure I put on it, the more the spring can expand or retract. And so I want to be careful when I'm getting down to my very fine cleanup.
What other mounting attachments are available for this machine?
Okay, good question. Yeah, right here we have the universal mount attached to it, but we also do offer a three-jaw chuck. And that three-jaw chuck can really save you a lot of time. You're kind of building an erector set here with the universal mount. And the three-jaw will drop in and then advance out to the diameter that you're after.
What are my options when mounting this valve with studs in place?
Okay, yeah, good question. So so we have what we call the erectors, or these ability to adjust the height of the universal chuck. The feet on the universal chuck also have a hole so that they can slip over most size studs until you get into the very large ones. But yeah, there's no real limit other than you want to keep the machine as rigid as you can. But to getting up over the studs, we can always make accommodations for that. And also with the three-jaw chuck, we have the stud adapters, which go out on the end of the feet that are concave that allow you to center that up on the studs themselves.
What are advantages and disadvantages of two different motor types?
Yeah, good question. So the electric motor is a DC motor that's going to be very controllable for RPM. It's going to be a real smooth, consistent rotation speed based on what you set and the amount of pressure you have on it. But like with any DC motor, it's running brushes, and some areas you're not going to want an open brush, you know, making sparks. The pneumatic air motor is a better duty cycle. In other words, if this thing has to run for long periods of time, I mean like 8 hours, 10 hours, you have a better duty cycle with a pneumatic motor. You also have a little more, you can run it a little harder with valves that need a little bit more attention. So, I mean, I think for the most part, it's whether you're in an environment where you can have an open brush or not. That's usually the deciding factor.
Is there a guide in the manual for planet wheel setup of different size seats?
Yes, there is. Yeah, I believe it's like page 17 in the manual that has the diagram of the wheel, the arms, and then the individual discs. And there's a chart that you go through to dictate what size. Now, obviously, each planet wheel has a range, and they're marked with an indicating line that allows you to set the arm with, you know, the disc out on the end. So, and you want to make sure those are even.
What are common applications for this machine?
For this machine, globe valves are mainly what it was designed for. In the fracking industry, the slab gate valve seat pockets, also it's real good for that. Some main steam isolation valves, it can fit in. I mean, basically it's a good ability to make a flat surface on a ceiling surface and give you the finish that you're after. Okay, well, that looks like all the questions for now. But again, Keep the questions coming. Keep the suggestions coming on what machines you'd like to see. And so after this time of this time together that we have, any questions that you have, go ahead and post those to askcpmt@cpmt.com, and we'll have somebody that can get back to you on those questions, or we'll take that information in and we'll add those to our next videos. All right, well, thanks a lot for joining, and we'll see you next time.